فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
They are what? They are different. Yes or no, brothers? 28 we have. Okay. Minus 3. Minus 3, Imran. Yeah? Shahid, is he right? Yeah? Is he right? Abbas. So 28, if you minus 3, you're with, left with what? 25. These 25 letters in Arabic are called huruf sahiha. They are huruf which is sahiha. They are healthy, good letters. Okay? The three that I took out are, in English we will call them the naughty letters. Arabic they call them huruf. حروف العلة. They're not healthy. They're sick. They're ill. If you want to remember those three letters, it's very easy to just remember it as Y. صح? Why? Because some of you might say, why these three? Well, it's Y, isn't it? Waw, Alif, and Ya. Are we all together? Brothers and sisters, are we together? Waw, Alif, and Ya are three naughty letters. They don't behave themselves. They're an exception. We're talking about here, what chapter are we in right now? What chapter did we just start? I'rab. Just to show you how the classes are connected. How many categorization did we categorize the af'al? Hayya Abdurrahman. Af'al, how many categorization? How many types of af'al are there? La. I'm talking about the tenses. How many types of af'al are there? Three. Jameel. What are they? Madi, mudari'. Do it in order. Madi, mudari', amar. Good. Hayya. How much is the asma'? How much do we categorize the nouns into? The first one was what? Abdulhad, how much was it? The asma', the nouns. How many is it? Four, five? Is it how much? Three, Jameel. So we keep going on these three. Remember these three, okay? Okay, hey, what's the three? So the first one is what? Mudhar. The second one was what? Mudmar. The third one was what? Mubham. Hey, Saad, how much did we categorize the huruf into? What are they? So the first harf that we chose was what? Mushtarak bayn al asma'i wal af'al. The second one was what? مختص بالأسماء. And the third one was what? مختص بالأفعال. Now that we are in the chapter of إعراب, حرف has gone. We don't talk about حروف anymore. You will never see us talk about حروف. In إعراب, حرف goes and it never comes in. It doesn't come into the discussion. We don't do إعراب of حروف. Does that make sense to you? Nor do we do i'rab of the other two types of asma, which is mudmar and mubham. They don't come into the chapter of i'rab. Go, leave us. We don't want to see you guys. Mudmar, we're not going to see them. Go on. Dama'ir, they go. Whether it be mutakallim, or whether it be ghaib, or whether it be mukhatabah. Dama'ir, pronouns, go. They don't come here. Mubham. Whether it be asma which mawsula, asma which are ishara, they go. Leave us. هذا هذه هؤلاء, we don't do i'rab of. الذي التي التي, we don't do i'rab of. Are you with me? Does it make sense? So we've taken, we've dropped two from asma. What are we left with? One. What's the one that we're left with? Mudhar. We're only left with mudhar. Mudhar is the one we do i'rab of. Put that one here for us. What are we left with right now? Af'al. Af'al, the only one we do i'rab of af'al is what? Which one? مضارع. So if you hear the chapter of إعراب, what are you doing إعراب of? What are you doing إعراب of? Huh? اسم which is مضارع. أنا فعل which is مضارع. That's it. Are we all together? Yes or no? And I'm coming to the حروف علة. And I'm coming to the حروف which is صحيحة. And there's a reason why I mentioned. Pay attention here. حروف علة, they enter into an اسم which is ظاهر and they enter into a فعل مضارع. So that's what we do with إعراب, right? And what did the author here say? لفظاً أو تقديراً. حروف علة, these three naughty letters, واو, ألف, and ياء, they become the last letter for either an اسم ظاهر. Okay? اسم which is مظهر or ظاهر, whatever you call it. أنا فعل مضارع. Okay? We only mentioned what we do إعراب of. What do we do إعراب of? اسم. اسم مضمر. اسم which is مظهر, sorry. اسم which is مظهر. We do إعراب of. And we do إعراب of what? فعل. There's only times when فعل مضارع leaves إعراب. There's two times. When unu tawkid and unu, and with nisva connect to it. We're going to speak about that later when we come to it. But these are the two we do i'rab of. The naughty letters, they enter both of these. Wow, alif and ya. Because these two are i'rab, right? Are you there? Sorry, let me take that back again. We need to be precise now. The حروف, the واو, and the ألف, and the ياء, they all enter what? They enter the فعل مضارع. واو, ألف, ياء. صح؟ The اسم مظهر, you'll only see ألف and ياء. You will never see a حرف علة at the ending of a noun. A واو as a harf illah on a noun. You'll never see that. Are we all together? So for example, the waw would be yad'u. The alif would be what? Yas'a. The ya would be yat, yaqdi. Are you with me? Sah? The alif would be what for the ism? Hey, al fata, right? Al fata. And the ya would be al qadi. Are we all together? Does that make sense, students? You will find the waw, you will never find a ism, mudhar, ism which is zahir, that has a ya at the ending. Are you there? Ah, fadal. Yeah, this is alif maqsura, alif maqsura, no problem. Yeah, still alif. Still alif. Pay attention now. Brothers, are we all together? This is the trickiest part. If you learn this part, you will learn. The alif The reason why it can't show. What's the reason? What's the sabab for the alif? Why it can't show? They say the reason for it is at-ta'adhur. So al-alif is at-ta'adhur. Al-alif means at-ta'adhur, meaning it excused itself. It gave its excuse, it can't. Ah. As for the al-wawu and al-ya'u, they are both what? Al is tith qalu. The wa and the ya is a what? Istithqalu. What does istithqalu mean? Heavy. It's actually heavy. Mean it can be done. It can be done, but it's heavy. Allah did it in the Quran. What did he say in Surah Al-Kahf? Lan nad'uwa. Uwa. Wa. We place a fatha on top of it. Sahih? Does that make sense? لَن نَدْعُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهَ لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذَا شَطَطَ. Right? نَدْعُوَ. You can, but it's effort. It's not that it can't be done. But it's heavy if you do it on it. Sahih? It's istithqal. It's heaviness. As for the alif, like it is a ta'adhur. Ta'adhur means what? It doesn't accept it. Good. Does that make sense, brothers? Jameel? Let's go back to the matter now. And we're going to talk about more on the situations, inshallah ta'ala, in our next lesson, bi idhnillah al-kareem. Now we have to go back, inshallah ta'ala, when we were speaking about the issue of al-alif, which is ta'adhur, and al-waw, and the ya', which is istithqal. And that is a third one that the author rahimahullah mentions in the sharah, which is the one we call a third one, which we called munasaba. Munasaba. Munasaba means what? What does munasaba mean? So we know what at-ta'adhur means. You've explained that to us. You've told us what istithqal means, and you said it enters the waw and the alif, and the reason why is the word istithqal is used is because it's heavy, it can't be said on it. But what does the word al-munasaba mean when the grammarians use it? The word ghulam, kitab, is that, what's the last letter? What's the last letter for the word ghulam? Mim. Is mim from the huruf al-illah, from the three naughty letters, or is it from the huruf which are sahiha? Huruf which are sahiha. Kitab, the ba. Is it from huruf illa or is it from hurufu? Huruf sahiha, right? If I add a ya to it, and that ya is ya al mudaf, irhamukallah, attributing this ghulam, the boy, to me, or the book to myself, when in reality the ending of the word is actually the ba or the mim. This ya forces the mim or the letter before it, whether it be a ba, whether it be a mim or anything, it will force a kasra on it. So you say, gula mi kitabi. This haraka here is not what it should be. This is an incorrect haraka. It's an incorrect sign. So the question is, where is the original sign? We say it's muqaddar. Grammarians will say it's muqaddar, meaning it's hidden. Why? You can't say a ta'adhur. It's not a ta'adhur. And it is not istithqal. It's called munasaba. What's the munasaba? Because ya can't come except with a haraka before it that has it in terms of pronunciation. Does that make sense? So you say gula mi, kitabi, bay T. Does that make sense? This haraka, which is the kasra that's here right now, is not the right sign. Why couldn't the original sign being shown? Yeah, it said I'm a guest. Ba. Ba. I'm a guest. I'm here temporarily. I'm not going to be here forever. And I'm a guest. I deserve things to be changed for me. Do I not? He said, okay. Please place the kasra here. It's the conversation that happened between them. Then the ya' said, the ba' said, okay, I'll take it. But what about my sign? He said, make it muqaddar. Hi, say it's muqaddar. He said, but muqaddar has already been taken by two, which is ta'adhur and istithqal has already happened. What are we going to be then? He said, we're a new one. We're called munasabah. We're called day? Munasabah. Does that make sense? That's how the dialogue went, or it happened. Does that make sense to you? So the third one is what? And this is khas, specific to a noun. This one is only specific to a noun. You'll never see a munasabah for a fi'il. Yeah. Very good. Let's go back on something now. The ya, which is wulami. Can I go back on something now? What's the alamat of the verbs? We already took that. And what's the alamat of the noun? Yeah, what did we say? The alamat of each one was. Let's start with the verb. Verbs alamat were what? Al-Dhamma and Al-Fatha and Al-Sukun, right? That's a fi'il, right? Am I wrong, brothers? The alamat that a fi'il takes. It takes Dhamma, so you find a fi'il that has Dhamma on it. You find a fi'il that has Fatha on it. And you find a fi'il that has a sukun. A fi'il doesn't take kasra. It doesn't. Are we all together? No. Does that make sense to you guys? If the last letter is an alif, pay attention. If the last letter is an alif, it is only muqaddar two times. How many situations we have here of fi'il? Talking about fi'il. We have three halat that the fi'il goes through. If the last letter, the word yas'a, the last letter is a what? It's an alif. Alif maqsura, right? Yas'a. That's true or false? It is only muqaddar two times. Hala, when it's dhamma, yuqaddar. So we say, mana' min dhuhuriha ta'adhur. It's also muqaddar when it say fatha. Does that make sense? Muqaddar means it's hidden, it's implicit. The word muqaddar means it's implicit. Are you there? It's not explicit, it's implicit. You can't see it. It's there, but you can't see it. Does that make sense? But if the ending is a wow, like yad'u or yaqdi. If the last is a waw or a ya, tuqaddaru fi halatin wahida, it is only muqaddar one time. And that is when it's a what? Dhamma. Are you with me? When it's halatul fatha, are you there? It's not muqaddar. I said to you the ayah, لَن نَدْعُوَا, Allah said it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you with me? Now we move on to the ism. All of these examples, inshaAllah ta'ala, we're going to bring as much examples when we come to alamatul, right now, write it as theory. How many signs did we say that the ism has? Ism has what? Al-Dhamma. Jameel. And it also has what? Al-Fatha. It also has what? It also has kasra. The difference between them two is the last one. Okay? This one doesn't have kasra, it has sukun. This one doesn't have sukun, it has kasra. Okay. If the last letter is an alif, are you there? It's an ism, which is alif, like the word al-fata. All of the three situations is muqaddar. As I showed you before, جاء الفتاة, رأيت الفتاة, مررت بالفتاة. All three situations, what was it? Muqaddar. You couldn't see it, it was implicit. Was it not? And then the alif in the ism is always muqaddar. Every time it's muqaddar. It's never explicit, it's always implicit. Jameel. If it is a ya, because I said waw does not enter a, does waw enter an ism? A waw doesn't enter an ism. If it's a waw, sorry, if it's a ya, sorry, ism. If it's a ya, a waw doesn't enter an ism. If it's a ya, it is muqaddar two times. The first time is al-dhammah and al-kasra. Al-dhammah and al-kasra. It's not muqaddar on the fatha. Naam. Yeah, it's مقدر نعم. لا لا في محل رفع something else. في محل رفع something else. قضية آخر. We're going to إن شاء الله تعالى نفرق between that. Are you with me? But it means that you will not see the ضمة with your eyes. You won't see it. Your eyes will not see it. So the alif when it's اسم في حالة الضمة. When there's meant to be a ضمة there, it won't show. When there's meant to be a fatha, that it won't show. When there's a kasra meant to show, it won't show. None of the two. Just like you couldn't see the word al-fatha in any of the situations. Are you there? Very good. As for if it's a ya, waw doesn't enter an ism. I already said that to you. If it's a ya, like al-qadi. Are you with me? The word al-qadi, halatu al-dhammah, it's muqaddar. You can't say al-qadi, you can't say it. But I did say to you guys, it's min bab al-istithqal, it's heavy. You can't say it, but it's heavy. The Arabs will look at you like, why are you doing that for? Just to make it muqaddar, stop saying it. Does that make sense? It's istithqal, it means it's heavy. You can't say al-qadi, look at the effort I have to go through. Istithqal means heavy, look, al-qadi. It doesn't flow from the tongue. And in the Arabic language, you should avoid as much as you can if something is complicated and hard to be said. And the second one is when it's kasra. Are you with me? Al-qadi. Again, it's istithqal. But it's muqaddar. Are you there? Like in the halat al-fatha, it's not muqaddar. Does that make sense? Let's swiftly move on. Bi-idhnillahi al-bari'u. Let's go back. Bab al-i'rab, the chapter of i'rab. Al-i'rab, i'rab. تغيير, the changing of أواخر الكلمي, the changing of the ending of the words, لاختلاف العوامل, due to the different agents الداخلة عليها that entered onto it, لفظا, it can be a لفظا, which is أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ مريئا في المكتوب أو تقديرا. لفظا in English means explicit, that's what it means. أو تقديرا, تقديرا means implicit, and in Arabic translation is what, أن يكون مسموعا, ألا يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ وألا يكون مريئا في المكتوب. What does like an إعراب linguistically mean? Let's go to the شرح of the محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد. محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد يقول وأقول I will say الإعراب له معنيان. إعراب has two meanings. أحدهما, the first one is لغوي. The first one is what? The first one is what? It is لغوي. Okay. والآخر اصطلاحي. And the last one is اصطلاحي. One is a linguistic definition, which is لغوي. And اصطلاحي means the technical definition. أما معناه في اللغة, as for its meaning in the language, the linguistic meaning, فهو الإظهار والإبانة. It means to make something apparent and to make it clear. تقول, you will say, أعربت عما في نفسي إذا أبنته وأظهرته. I have أعربت means here I made it clear عما في نفسي that which was in my heart. Are you there? أعربت أظهرت I made it clear عما في نفسي that which is in my heart. So the word إعراب linguistically means that he now Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid there are three tarifs it has in the language. Are you there? Does that make sense? There are three meanings that it has in the language. He only chose one because this is the closest meaning. The other two meanings that it has in the language, we will take it when we do the sharah of Mutammimatu al-Ajrumiyya, sharah Kawakib al-Durriyya, we'll mention it for us there. وَأَمَّا مَعْلَاهُ فِي الْإِصْطِلَاحِ As for its definition, its technical definition, according to the grammarians, فَوَمَا ذَكَرَهُ الْمُؤَلِّفُ بِقَوْلِهِ تَغْيِيرُ أَوَاخِرِ الْكَلِمِ إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ It is what the author has mentioned. ما ذكره المؤلف It is what the author mentioned. بقوله with his statement تغيير أواخر الكلمة. This word إلخ. Can you see what it says there? It means إلى آخره. It means to the end. Okay, don't read it as إلخ. People laugh at you. It's like somebody tried to read etc. with ETC. Is it right to read it like that? It's an acronym, right? So ila alif lam and kha means ila akhirih to the ending. To the ending of what? Huwa taghyir awakhir al-kalim ikhtilaf al-awamil al-dakhilah 'alayhi lafdhan aw taqdiran. Take it to there. Aw taqdiran, that's the ending. Then the author says wal maqsoodu min taghyir awakhir al-kalim. Here it is, you see where I said it before, the author corrects him here. Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid puts a powerful point here, which is what? والمقصود the intent behind تغيير أواخر الكلم the changing of the ending of the word is تغيير أحوالي look at the word he has in there أحوال so you underline the word أحوال تغيير the changing of what أحوالي the situation of أواخر الكلم it's the changing of the situation not the changing of the wording it's not تغيير نفس الأواخر ولا يعقل and it is not understood أن يراد تغيير نفس الأواخر نفس الأواخر. It doesn't mean that the letter itself will change. فإن آخر الكلمة نفسه لا يتغير. Because the last ending of the word doesn't change. What changing is the situation of it. The حركات is what changes. وتغيير أواخر الكلمة عبارة عن تحولها من الرفع إلى النصب أو الجزم حقيقة أو حكما. It is the changing. Are you there? Brothers, pay attention. وتغيير أواخر وتغيير the changing of what أحوالي the situation of the last letter that's what changes the dal doesn't change from زيد or محمود the dal doesn't change it doesn't change what changes is the situation and the context that it goes in it changes the حركات that's what changes and he says أن تحولها من الرفع إلى النصب أو الجر it changes from what it changes from رفع like what جاء زيد this is رفع because it's a فاعل إلى النصب to نصب which is what رأيت زيدا زيدا هي is نصب أو الجري مررت بزيد this is the جر all the three situations I wrote on the board before but the author here brought something very tricky he said حقيقة أو حكمة sometimes it will change literally and sometimes it will change in terms of ruling what does he mean by حكمة حقيقة we understand is what we took all day But hukman, why did he bring it? This is a bit tricky, and it's something that normally shouldn't come in a jurumiyya like this. Something that you will await for in other books, Alfiyah and other books like that. But since he mentioned it, we will mention it. As you all know, the Arabic language, an ism cannot be two letters. That's not an ism. Ism generally should not be two letters. The minimum an ism can be is how much? Three or more. But there are some words that have been found, are you there? That are not three letters. Sorry, that are not two, that are two letters and they're an ism. Like the word yad and the word dam, blood. So what's the situation? The word yad, it used to have, or it does have, at the ending of it, a wow. It's yadu, yadu, There's a wow there. Are you there, brothers? So because of that word, the ulama al-nahwi, they gave it a hukum, a ruling. We're not going to go more than that. We'll explain on it and expand on it when we come to Qatr al-Nada, inshaAllah ta'ala. Or even the mutammima of Ajrumiyah. Does that make sense? That's what he's talking about here. I'll conclude here, inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, incorrect, is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. SubhanAllah, wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.